Thank you. Assalamu alaikum and a very good morning to all of you. So today my talk will be about folic acid and birth defects. I have three chapters, other tiga bab. I don't say the title yet because I want to make it a bit of a surprise. So bila-bila satu ibu mengandung, dia harap anak akan nampak comel dan akan nampak sempurna. So I think whenever a mother is pregnant, she expects the baby to be very cute and almost looking perfect. So this baby looks very cute, isn't it? But sometimes, berlaku, masa baby lahir, shock. Okay, when the baby is born, then it's like a shock, okay? The baby is not looking sempurna. The baby is not looking so cute, actually. The baby has a major defect in the face. Ya ada masalah besar dalam muka. Ya ada cleft lip. Okay, so cleft lip is a very common birth defect. Baby sumbang, kerap kali berlaku. So kalau ni berlaku, ibu bapa sedih, shock. The baby is not as cute and as perfect as was anticipated and expected during the delivery. But luckily, kita boleh bedah. We can operate this condition. We have a treatment for this baby sumbang. And this baby, which I showed in the first slide, is actually the same baby as I showed just now. But after operation, if you look with some details, you can see a little bit of scar tissue at the lip, maybe, which we didn't notice on the first slide. But this is a condition we can operate on. So how common is it? Berapa kali berlaku? About 1 in 700 births. For every baby, every 700 babies born, there's about one baby who gets this cleft lip, cleft palate. So every year in USM, we have 7,000 births, 7,000 orang beranak di USM. Jadi 10 anak kena dengan masalah ni di USM sahaja. In HRPZ, in the other big hospital in Kota Baru, we have 14,000 deliveries per year. So about 20 babies from there. Then in the other hospitals in Kelantan, about 9,000 births. So another 10 to 13 babies in the other hospitals as well. So seluruh, kita dapat every year about 40 babies in Kelantan dapat masalah ini. So the next question is, boleh jadi 20? Dari 40, kita boleh buat 20. Ini sangat susah, isn't it? From 40 to 20. How do we get from 40 to 20? Oops, sorry. The previous. I think it doesn't show nicely. So, one way to reduce it, maybe we can send all the babies to Terengganu deliver. Half of the babies to Terengganu, then maybe only half of the babies born here. That would be one way, isn't it? Okay, but it's not a very good way, isn't it? Another way to reduce the number, maybe we can make small families instead of big families. If half of the babies only deliver, half of the babies will have the problem. But that's also maybe not a very good idea. We like big families. Kita suka keluarga besar. Kita suka ramai kanak-kanak ni. So there's a better way actually to reduce this number from 40 to 20. And that better way is by using folic acid. Okay, so if the mothers are taking folic acid, bila-bila ibu makan folic acid, satu jenis ubat, but it's not ubat actually, it's just vitamin. If the mothers take this vitamin meticulously, we can reduce the number from 40 to 20 in Kelantan every year. So there's at least a close to 50% reduction if the mother takes prophylactic folic acid. So how many of the present ladies between 20 to 40 years old take folic acid now? Nobody? Why not? It's a very simple prevention, which is possible. The problem is some of us don't know it. The problem is some of us know it, but don't take the effort to make this prevention. We are not too much worried about this. Sampai berlaku. So I think it's sometimes a lack of knowledge, it's sometimes a lack of practice, even if we know. So I think this folic acid is a very important tool that can help decrease this very important birth defect, yang kita panggil cleft lip atau bibir sumbing. So the shock that the parents experience at birth can be prevented in half of the cases if just all the women of childbearing age would take folic acid every day. So it's important that we understand a little bit about the development of the fetus, perkembangan kanak-kanak. So I think I can go to. Oops. Stand here. So there's fetal development. How long are women pregnant? Do you know? It's 40 weeks, okay? Kita kira dari hari pertama, from the first day of the last menstrual period. So the last period, hari pertama, sampai delivery, sampai beranak, is 40 weeks, 40 minggu. Okay, so apa yang sangat penting? Minggu-minggu yang pertama. So in the next slide, I show you what happens in the first 4 weeks after the first day of the last menses. So the first day of the last menstruation, the last period. Ada dua minggu, biasa lepas dua minggu ada ovulasi, dan masa tu fertilization berlaku. Okay. So masa dua minggu lepas hari pertama period terakhir, the fertilization berlaku. Lepas tu dua minggu lagi, kita tak tahu lagi kita mengandung. Bila kita tahu, lepas satu bulan. Okay, satu bulan, period tak datang, oh, mungkin kita mengandung. bukan kita, awak. mungkin mengandung. Tapi, very important to understand, between the fertilization and the time we know that you, not we, know that you are pregnant, so between the time that between the fertilization and the knowledge of being pregnant, ada dua minggu dah. Dan dua minggu tu sangat penting. Sebab dua minggu tu sangat penting untuk semua organ jadi. Okay, kita panggil the organogenesis. So these 2 weeks are very important for the construction and the development of the organs. And during these 2 weeks, it's already berlaku kalau ada baby sumbing. So if there's a cleft palate or a cleft lip, already happens during these first 2 weeks. So if we start eating folic acid only after we know that we are pregnant, it's too late because the problem has already occurred. So we cannot allow, if we start eating folic acid after we mengandung, after we tahu kita mengandung, it's too late to have this preventive effect for the lip. But we still eat folic acid after mengandung because it can reduce also the problems of a lack of sel darah merah, the problems of anemia. So it's beneficial for other things. But for the prevention of cleft lip, it's not useful to eat after you know already you're pregnant. So we have to eat before pregnancy. So this is very important. To be effective, we have to eat folic acid before we're pregnant, before you're pregnant. We as humans say, I don't. Okay. So this folic acid can have a very beneficial effect. It can reduce up to 50%. Some studies say 25%, some studies say 50%, up to 50% of the cases of this cleft lip. But we have to eat it at least 2 months to 3 months before that we get pregnant. So how can we know when we get pregnant? Eh? Some of us know, okay, we run chang and then we can plan. We can really plan it, and 2 months before we plan to get pregnant, then we start eating. And even if we get pregnant after 6 months, still we continue eating, and then it's okay. But sometimes we don't plan that much. So that's why for every woman of childbearing age, every woman between 20 or 18 to 45 years old, kita mengalahkan untuk makan tiap hari folic acid. So well, whether you rancang or not, sometimes it comes without rancang as well, isn't it? So I think every woman between 18 to 45, we encourage them to eat every day one tablet of folic acid. And this will reduce our birth defects very markedly. Not only this cleft lip, because in my BAB 2 and my BAB 3, I will talk about other diseases which are preventable as well. So this folic acid is present in food as well. So why we want to take pills if it's present in food as well? Where in which foods we can find it? Vegetables. But the problem is, all of us eat vegetables, but most of us eat cooked vegetables, isn't it? Not many of us eat raw salad and all these things. Eh? Salad is something in Europe, isn't it? In Malaysia, we eat cooked vegetables. Dalam proses masak sayur, hilang folic acid. Okay, so in the process of cooking our vegetables, we lose this folic acid. And what happens then? We get the lack of folic acid in many women who are pregnant. Fruits, nuts contain folic acid as well. But even the folic acid in fruits and nuts is not as easily reabsorbed in our gut as the one we give in the tablets, which is a slightly different form of folic acid. So in many Western countries, they have tried the women to eat folic acid, like we are trying for quite some time already to convince the women of Malaysia to take the tablets. But it's not very easy to make people eat a tablet every day, even though it has very, very good effects. So what have they done in Europe? They fortify the bread. So every piece of roti, dalam roti, dia tambah folic acid. Then tarafolic acid in the community is going up, and all these diseases which are preventable going down. But here, we don't eat bread, or we eat very few bread. So can we not fortify the rice? The problem is, again, the rice we are cooking, and in the cooking process, it will be lost. So the rice, we cannot fortify. Would be nice if we can fortify the rice. It's rhyme, isn't it? Would be very good, actually, if we can fortify the rice. But we cannot, because in the cooking process, it will be lost. So we are stuck with our tablets still, I think. So folic acid tablets, I think, very, very important for women of childbearing age. Is this cleft lip genetic? Ini satu penyakit keturunan? The answer is yes, and the answer is also no. So it's a little bit genetic. But because there are many factors playing a role. So there's a genetic predisposition. So if you have certain genes, then it increases the chance of having children with this condition. So if you have one child with cleft, ada satu anak yang kena dengan bibir sumbing, ada 4% kemungkinan ada anak seterusnya dapat juga. So there's a 4% chance to have recurrence of this condition in subsequent children. So 1 in 700, jadi 1 in 25. So it becomes much more common if you have already one child. So I think for women who have already one child with one of these preventable conditions, it becomes more important still to eat folic acid. Because one of the other factors, factor line, factor environment, one of these factors is certain to be folic acid. So if we can modify at least the folic acid, the genetic, kita tak boleh modify, kita tak boleh tukar gene kita. Tapi the folic acid level in our blood we can tukar just by eating one tablet per day. This is a picture of Jules Leroy, With Jules Leroy, he was my boss before. When I was trained for pediatrics, he was the professor in pediatrics. And he was a professor not only in pediatrics, but also in genetics. Oops, I think this animation not going. There is Jules Leroy. There. Okay. So he was a professor in genetics, and he became a professor in genetics because he had three siblings who had cleft lip and palate. And that makes him interested in genetics, actually. He wanted to study all this genome and how the genes came about, because he had three of his siblings had cleft lip and palate. So he was a very bright guy. He did not study about cleft lip and palate, finally, but he found out a new disease. He discovered a new disease which was named after him. There's a disease of Jules Leroy, actually. And it's the eye cell disease. It's one rare disease, but he was discovering a new disease in humans, so I think it's a big achievement. I'm a bit proud of this guy, so that's why I bring him up. But I think the interesting part of, he became professor of genetics because three of his siblings had this condition. So by that time, we didn't know about this folic acid yet. So maybe you can say, okay, cleft lip, if we have an operation, then the baby looks okay. But it's not like that. This baby with one operation, this cerita tak habis lagi. Kalau baby dapat satu pembedahan, tak cukup. Sebab ni pembedahan untuk baby sahaja. Dalam mulut, ada sembuh juga. So in the mouth, there's also a problem. So it's not just one operation. It's many operations. They have to operate also the palate. They have also to operate the teeth. And they have to operate many, many times. Some of these babies born with cleft lip and palate need up to 20 operations before they're doing well. Because if it's not semua correct dalam mulut, ada kesan atas bercakap, kita bertutur. Okay, so our speech will be affected by a problem with our palate. So this palate needs to be okay. And then our teeth need to be okay. So some of these babies need up to 20 operations. So it's not a very simple condition. It's a severe condition we can prevent by eating this folic acid. And this baby has just one side, the cleft. Some babies have the cleft on two sides. And it's more severe still. It's looking worse, isn't it? So it's more complex, and the operations are more complex still to correct it. So far we have seen, if babies are born with cleft lip or cleft palate, it's a shock at birth. It causes feeding problems. The operation can restore the cosmetics, but multiple operations are necessary for the palate. And this is preventable, not 100% preventable, but 50% of the cases are preventable by eating one tablet of folic acid every day before pregnancy. So I think this is a very important message. So this severe thing can be prevented by folic acid. So now we go to BAP2. For BAP2 is actually about another disease, a disease which is worse still than cleft lip and cleft palate, which is also preventable by folic acid. And these are the neural tube defects. So what is a neural tube defect? Is when the baby is born, the saraf keluar dari badan. So biasa saraf ditutup dengan kulit, dengan tulang, dengan semua. Tapi kadang-kadang tak tutup sebelum lahir. Dan dia boleh keluar dari belakang atau dari kepala juga. So sometimes babies are born with a neural tube defect, and some of the neuronal tissue is exposed before birth. The big problem is if it is exposed, maybe we can tutup juga ni, we can just cover with kulit. But the problem is, if we cover with kulit, this neural tissue sudah rosak. Okay, so before birth, when they stuck tutup, the exposed to the amniotic fluid, and it's not tolerating this very well. So the neuronal tissue rosak. Apa kesan kalau neuronal tissue dari belakang rosak? What is the effect? So this is just showing in a little bit more detail what berlaku. Okay. So there, normal spine tutup, here exposed. And all this spinal tissue rosak. So one of the effects is on the feet. Because these nerves that is in it, they go to our legs and our feet. So the baby cannot move the feet. If the baby cannot move the feet get deformed. Eh? Because before birth, the baby is kicking. Eh? I think all of you who have been pregnant, they know that the baby is kicking before birth. The baby is moving. And because the baby is moving the feet, the feet remain in a normal position. But if the baby cannot move the feet are just taking the shape of the environment of the uterus. So this deformation is very common in these babies with spina bifida, with this neural tube defect. So this is quite a bad thing to happen, isn't it? One, the baby cannot use his feet, he cannot walk, and he has deformed feet on top of that. So the start-off is very important for the kaki and for the legs. But that's not all. Because this saraf dari sini also penting untuk puning kencing kita, for the bladder. So these babies may have a neurogenic bladder. Neurogenic bladder means the saraf yang pergi ke puning kencing tak jalan. And then incontinence, baby tak boleh simpan air kencing. Can lead to urine retract infection, sometimes very bad. Can rosak the kidney. Okay, so some of these babies need to be catheterized. The father and the mother needs to put in a small tube to evacuate the urine to prevent infections. And later they have to do it themselves. So it's a very complex disease, actually, this neural tube defect. Very a disease with a lot of consequences. These babies require a lot of medical attention for their feet. They require a lot of medical attention for their whooping lung, for their kidney. And that's not all still. Also, this saraf is going to the usus, to the bowels. And this leads to constipation and sometimes fecal incontinence as well. Yata boleh simpan najis juga. So all these things happen if the baby is born with this defect. So I think this defect is much worse still than the cleft lip and cleft palate. And this also can be prevented with folic acid. So I think you could be convinced already, just for this cleft lip, cleft palate, it's already worth taking the folic acid. But if that was not worth it, this definitely makes worth it, because also this can be reduced 20% by 50%. Another problem, in the same baby with this problem at the back, most of them develop hydrocephalus. What is hydrocephalus? There's too much water in the head, and the head grows big and big and big. Unless we put in a drain. We put in a small tube that can drain out the fluid. And that's done. So this is an example of a baby with hydrocephalus. So this baby's head is too big for the body. So this baby was born with a spina bifida. He had all these problems with the legs, with the bladder and the usus. And on top of that, his head was growing too big and he needed an operation for evacuating the water of the head. Okay, so all these things, the masala can be reduced by 50% if we take folic acid. And that's very important. Okay, so is it common? It's almost as common as the baby stumbling. It's almost as common. 1 in 800, just now was 1 in 700. So it's close to 40, maybe 35 to 40 per year in Kelantan as well. So how to reduce the incidence by 50%? Again, we could send everybody to Terengganu, but I think much better, much better, I think, is folic acid, isn't it? Folic acid can reduce this by 50%. So I think this is really convincing. I'm convinced, okay? I really want every woman in Kelantan to eat folic acid. Every day, one tablet. And we can prevent half of the cases of not only the cleft lip and palate, but also half of the cases of this neural tube defects. Okay, and that's what I just showed now. It was the neural tube defect of the back. Sometimes it's at the head, and this one can also be prevented by folic acid. So this is when it doesn't close at the head. A big part of the brain, this is a sac filled with fluid coming out of the head at the back. This baby needs operation as well. And if there's not a lot of brain tissue in there, then it's okay. But sometimes there's brain tissue in there as well, and then it's not okay. Sometimes it's in the front of the face. And these babies need operations as well. And it's all problematic and shocking and invasive, and all can be reduced by half by folic acid. So folic acid can reduce by 50%. Cleft lip, cleft palate, spina bifida, the back problem, and kyphoselial, the problem on the head and the back or on the front, all these things can be reduced by close to 50% just by eating one tablet of folic acid before pregnancy. Is that all? No. So there's also a Baptiger. Okay. So Baptiger is, I will be very short, Baptiger, okay? I cannot make it too long, I'm running out of time, I think. So this is the only slide for my Baptiger. It can also reduce the congenital heart defects. So this baby is born with congenital heart defects. You can see the baby is not nice and pink. This baby looking blue, cyanosed, okay? And it's due to a congenital heart defect. Also, the congenital heart defects can be reduced by 25 to 50%. Some studies say 50%, some studies say 25%. But it can have a marked effect on the incidence of congenital heart defects. We don't want babies with cleft lip. We don't want babies with cleft palate. We don't want babies with all these abnormalities, isn't it? And definitely also not with a heart, isn't it? So if this, we can prevent these very severe conditions by just taking one tablet of vitamin, but they, I think we all should take it. So folic acid can reduce by 50%, not only cleft lip, palate, and spina bifida and kyphoselial, but also the heart defects. So, are you convinced? I hope so. I hope everybody who is of childbearing age will take from today onwards folic acid one tablet per day. Very important to stress, it needs to be taken before pregnancy, and because if not, we will miss these crucial 2 weeks, the first 2 weeks where all the organs are formed. Is there any other benefits of folic acids? It can reduce, in normal persons, adults, the incidence of heart disease. It's not 100% proven, but there are studies proving, and there are studies showing that it reduces heart disease, other studies showing it doesn't. But it's not negative for the heart. It may have a positive effect on the incidence of myocardial infarction and other heart diseases of the adults. It can improve memory. So there's quite a number of studies that are showing a beneficial effect on memory loss in old age. It can reduce anemia, and that's why many pregnant women take it. Even after this crucial 2 weeks, we still give it during the rest of the pregnancy for the treatment of anemia of pregnancy, the lack of red blood cells in pregnancy. It can reduce certain cancers. There's quite some evidence that it may be reducing colorectal cancers. For other cancers, the evidence is equivocal. I think it may increase the lung cancers in smokers. So if you smoke, don't take folic acid. But better don't smoke, ne? Don't smoke and take folic acid, okay? So, if we take too much of it, it may be excreted in the urine. So I think too much is not as dangerous. Some vitamins are lipid soluble and they can accumulate in our body and it can become dangerous. But this one is a water soluble. So if we take too much of it, it will be just going out our body in the urine. So the dangers are very limited. And the potential benefits are really very much. So my main message is, if you are a woman of childbearing age, please take your folic acid every day. Okay, I think this is my last slide. Yes, so thank you for your attention.